Good morning, my dear students of class 10. Today we will continue the chapter life processes, and today's topic is transportation. So what is transportation? Transportation means movement of materials from one place to another. So what is transportation? What is transportation? Transportation means movement of materials from one place to another according to their availability. That means place where it is present in more amount, from that place it will move to another place where it is absent or is in less amount. Okay, so this is the according to the availability. Okay, from their most available region to the less available region, the materials will be transported. So what is transportation? Transportation means movement of materials from the one place to another place, and it will be according to their availability. Okay, what materials would be transported? So there are different types of materials which will be transported. So what are they? Oxygen, carbon dioxide, nutrients, waste material. So oxygen, carbon dioxide, nutrients, waste materials, water, minerals. So these, except that there are some materials also present which will be transported. These are the some examples, that is oxygen, carbon dioxide, nutrients, water, waste materials. These all will be transported. Okay, so in our book there is transportation in human being. So we will see that in our transportation system, what is there? So in case of transportation in human beings, it is called as also circulatory system. That means it is carried out by circulatory system. And in human circulatory system, there are some parts. These are, it is made up of heart, blood, blood vessels. Carried out, what are the different parts of circulatory system? That is blood, heart, that is a pumping organ, and there is a circulating fluid which is called as blood, and some tubes like structures which are called as blood vessels. And what are the different types of blood vessels? They are artery, vein and capillary. Artery, vein and capillary, these are the different types of blood vessels. Okay, so our human circulatory system is made up of all this. So we will read one by one. Today we will start with the blood, that is circulating fluid. We'll start with the blood. So what is blood? Blood is a fluid connective tissue. In our class 9, you have read that part, that is what is connective tissue and what is fluid connective tissue. So blood is an example of fluid connective tissue, and it is reddish in color. The color of the blood is reddish. Okay, why? Because an iron containing pigment which is called as hemoglobin, it is present inside the blood, and that's why it is usually reddish in color. Okay, and what is the pigment? Hemoglobin. Okay, and we can say that two types of bloods we will find, that is oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. So oxygenated blood means when hemoglobin helps in transport of oxygen and carbon dioxide. When oxygen is bound with that hemoglobin, that is called as oxygenated blood, and their term is oxyhemoglobin. Oxygen will bind with hemoglobin and they will form oxyhemoglobin, and that type of blood is called as oxygenated blood when oxygen is present. And when carbon dioxide is with hemoglobin, it is called as carbaminohemoglobin, or that type of blood is called as deoxygenated blood. Okay, so blood is carrying that oxygen and carbon dioxide along with hemoglobin. Okay, and there are different functions of blood. We will look into that one by one. So that is the main types of blood, and now not types, that is the some, that are the some properties of blood. Now we will find that amount of blood in our body. 5 to 6 liters of blood is present. Normally it is 5 to 6 liters. And now we look the different components of blood. So blood is consist of mainly plasma and blood cells. So blood is mainly composed of plasma and blood cells. So about 55% is plasma, and rest of the part, that is 45% of the blood, is blood cells and corpuscles. So what is plasma? Plasma is pale yellow in color. It is a fluid part of the blood, and plasma is pale yellow or straw in color, and it is fluid part of the blood. About in case of plasma, about 90% to 92% water is present, and about 8% to 10% solutes are present. Okay, inside that plasma, 90 to 92% is water, and 8 to 2% is solutes. And inside that solute, what are the different components? That will be nutrients, excretory products, inorganic gases, hormones. Okay, these are present inside that plasma. And it is slightly alkaline in nature. Plasma is slightly alkaline in nature. And in that plasma, you will find a substance which is called as heparin. And it is an anticoagulant. Anticoagulant means which will not allow our blood to clot. Okay, so that's why inside our blood body, blood will not clot. Why? Because of the presence of this heparin. So a heparin is present, and heparin does not allow blood to clot inside our blood vessels. But whenever it will be outside of our body, that time we have seen that blood clots. But inside our body, due to the presence of heparin, blood will not clot, and that heparin is present inside the plasma. Next part is blood vessels or blood corpuscles. We have written another term, blood corpuscles. Corpuscles means cells which can move freely. Okay, as you can see that blood cells can move freely inside that part. So that's why blood cells are called as blood corpuscles. Okay, and all the cells can move freely, as we know that. So now we can conclude that all corpuscles are cells, but all cells are not corpuscles. I am repeating, all corpuscles are cells, but all cells are not corpuscles, as only blood cells can move freely. That's why blood cells are called as blood corpuscles. Okay, now we will see the different types of blood cells or blood corpuscles. There are three types of blood cells or blood corpuscles. First one is RBC. The full form of RBC is red blood cell. Second one WBC, the full form of WBC is white blood cell, and third one is platelets. And the alternative of RBC is erythrocytes, the alternative of WBC is leukocytes, and the alternative name of platelets is thrombocytes. Okay, so first we will see the RBC. What is RBC? What is the color of the RBC? That is a hemoglobin is present inside that RBC. Okay, that's why it is red in color. Okay, it is red in color due to the presence of iron containing pigment, which is called as hemoglobin. What is the shape of that structure? That is circular and biconcave. Okay, it is look like that. Okay, and nucleus is absent in case of RBC. That's why it is called as enucleated. That means nucleus is absent in case of RBC. And what is the number of RBCs? That is 4.5 to 5 million per ml of blood. 4.5 to 5 million per ml of blood. That is the number of blood RBC in case of human, and in case of males the number is quite high than females. So, and in RBC, why nucleus is absent? And not only nucleus, some cell organelles are also absent in case of RBC, because they have to pass through the blood vessels, and it is a thin channel. That's why if they insert that cell organelle and nucleus, the size will be larger, so that they will not be able to pass freely. That's why these many cell organelles and nucleus is absent in case of RBC. What is the lifespan of RBC? That is 120 days. The lifespan of RBC is 120 days. After 120 days, the RBC will be destroyed inside the liver and spleen. That's why it is spleen is called as graveyard of RBC. Okay, so these are the common features of RBC, and it is what is the function of RBC? That is, it helps to transport some metals like oxygen, carbon dioxide, etc. Okay, and next part is WBC. Don't forget that we are reading only human blood. Okay, so WBC is of mainly two types, that is granulocyte and agranulocyte. Granulocytes mean this, in this type of WBC granules will be present, and agranulocytes mean in this type of WBC granules will be absent. Okay, and under the granulocyte you find three types, that is neutrophil, eosinophil and basophil, and under the agranulocyte that is monocyte and lymphocyte. So what is WBC? As the term indicates, that it is white in color. And what is the number? That is 5,000 to 8,000 WBCs are present per ml of blood. Okay, that is the number of WBC. So they are colorless, and nucleus present. So inside the WBC we will see the nucleus is present, and they are usually colorless. Okay, and the normal value is 5,000 to 8,000 per ml of blood, and the lifespan of WBC is 12 hours to few days. So WBC can survive for 12 hours or it can survive few days. So now we will look into the types of WBCs, that is granulocyte and agranulocyte, and we will see the picture of that. That is So under the granulocyte, WBC is granules are present. So these dots are showing the granules and nucleus is lobulated. Okay, nucleus is present and in case of granulocyte WBC, mainly nucleus is lobulated. Means lobes are present in the nucleus. So in case of neutrophil, there are near about 3 to 5 nucleus is present. Sorry, lobes are present in the nucleus. That is, these are the different lobes. And in case of eosinophil, it looks like overhead head cone. The lobes of the nucleus looks like overhead head cone. And the last one is basophil. That is also nucleus is lobulated. Okay. And next part is a granulocyte whose nucleus are usually non-lobulated. Look, the nucleus, they are not lobulated. Okay, this is the nucleus in case of monocyte, and in case of lymphocyte, it looks like that. Okay. And now we have to know what are the different functions of WBC. WBC helps in our immunity. Okay, it helps to fight against to various types of germs and pathogens. Clear? So in case of WBC, they can do phagocytosis. Phagocytes will help to engulf the germ cells. Okay, and that is immunocytes. Immunocytes will secrete antibodies, which will help in our immunity to fight against different germs and pathogens. Okay, so these are the main types of WBC and main function of WBC. Next, we will proceed to the platelets. So platelet is usually colorless, non-nucleated. That means nucleus is also absent in case of platelets. So platelet is usually colorless and nucleus is absent. And what is the number of platelets? That is 0.15 to 0.45 million per mL of blood. That is the average number of platelets. And what is the lifespan of platelets? That is near about 7 to 10 days. And what is the function of platelets? It helps in blood clotting. Platelets helps in blood clotting. Okay. So what is blood clotting or how blood clots? We will see in our next class. Okay. So now we have read the different components of the blood. And if I say that, tell me the what are the difference between WBC and RBC. So you can write easily. So if you consider the some points, like in case of difference. So if we consider shape, if we consider the what is the shape of that is circular, biconcave. Okay, and in case of it is rounded, okay, WBC, so it is circular, biconcave, and it is, in case of RBC, it is rounded. Okay, so next property, that is types. So in case of the RBC, there are only one type, and in case of WBC, they are mainly one type, and in case of WBC, we have found 5 types of WBC. So next point is nucleus. If we consider the nucleus, it is absent in case of WBC, and it is absent in case of RBC, and it is present in case of WBC. Hemoglobin. So hemoglobin is present in case of WBC, but hemoglobin is absent in case. Hemoglobin is present in case of RBC, but hemoglobin is present in case of WBC. Okay. So, if I consider any cell organelle, so cell organelle is, if we consider cell organelle, as I have mentioned that cell organelles are mainly absent in case of RBCs and present in case of WBCs. Okay. And next, if we consider the number, of RBC, you know, 4.5 to 5 million per ml of blood, but in case of WBC, that is 5,000 to 8,000 per ml of blood. Next, if we consider the function, you know the function, it helps in transport of oxygen and carbon dioxide, and in case of RBC, it helps to fight against many diseases and it helps in our immunity. Okay, so now we have completed the blood part. In our next class we will see the blood clotting, how blood clots and different types of blood vessels. Okay, so thank you.